sparkling of a truncated composite cone under axial compression. Hey dear viewers, this is Ronald speaking, and if this is your first time on the channel, please make sure to like, sub and subscribe. Now to the video. In this video we will take a look at this composite cone, which is an interstage adapter of the Ariane 5. The conical structure was tested and analyzed in this article. Here are the important material and geometry parameters and ratios. Okay, now let's go to Abacus. We start again with the linear bifurcation analysis. LBA, got part, shell, revolution, then we use create lines 400 and 0 and 190 and 300. Okay, 360 degrees. There he is. Okay, now we use data planes XY. YZ and XZ at 150 mm offset. Okay, now we cut the shell. We will create a coordinate system, cylindrical. Okay, origin is 0, 0, 0. Axis is 1, 0, 0, and this is 0, 0, 1. And now it's opposite. That's better. It was -1. Okay. Now we go to property. Create mechanical elasticity elastic here, type lamina, and the parameters. Okay. Now we go to part orientation, select the shell. Our coordinate system, and then we use this one, X2, yes. Okay, looks everything fine. Yes. Okay, back to property, create composite layer manager. Conventional shell, 6 initial ply count, continue. Okay, region, the shell, obviously. Material, material 1, thickness 0.125, angle, -40, -40, 0. is at 0, 0, 0. Second is at 0, 0, 0, 300, 0. Then we go to constraint manager, create constraint 1 rigid body, tie upper shell edge and point this one. Okay, and then rigid body again, tie this edge, this edge, this edge, and this edge, this point. Okay, now load initial displacement. Here everything is fixed, and here everything is fixed except the U2 or the Y direction. Okay, now load step 1 constraint force here -1. Okay, mesh part, mesh controls, free quad medial access, 6. Okay, that's it. Okay, create job LBA. Okay, next we create the GNA, copy GNA. Step place general static general on. This edge -1 millimeter, and then we will use a small imperfection here at this node and constrain U1 to 0. Okay, mesh, everything should be fine. Create GNA. There may be some error with the normal direction of the shell elements. You have to go to mesh, then assign stack direction, and here you can reverse the element normal if this is the case. This may happen sometimes. Okay, now to the results. I have already prepared the results. Ah, here LBA. Okay, here's the first linear buckling eye mode. Okay, the first linear buckling node is 48 kilonewtons. Now let's have a look at the GNA. Remember, here is a small displacement pre-described, which acts as a small imperfection. So we have here the buckling starts here, and here there's a post-buckling pattern. Let's have a look at the node displacement curve. Unique node. And compared to the experimental curve. That's it. This one, save. Go to operate on XY data. Combine. Ups. This one. Then here cover. Ups. This one. Plot. Ring node. It's 48 kilonewtons. Okay, now let's we will export those data report XY temp and K8. This is the name of the cone. Apply. Okay, now we only go to our Excel sheet. Here is the test data of the shell. I will just open quick the here is that data from Abacus. Getrennt. Okay, yeah. So we will have a higher buckling load as expected. The test buckling load is about 35. The perfect buckling load is about 48. So the knockdown factor is about 0.73. The stiffness of the model corresponds very well. We could do an imperfection analysis in a later video. Okay, but that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and until next time.